Good morning, church. We join each other from across the world on different devices in different time zones, yet we continue to be drawn by the same truth. No matter who we are, no matter where we are on life's journey, we are welcome here. Let us begin our time of worship with our call for worship. Let us read responsively. Arise, shine, for your light has come. Tell the good news throughout the earth. Come and adore the Savior of the nations. Our sin. God of grace, you call us to generosity. You are generous towards us, yet we often hold back. You give us the gift of time to serve, learn, grow, and share, yet we often spend our time serving self. You have given us talents and abilities, yet at times we hide our gifts. Lord, in your mercy, forgive us. Remind us that you are a God of abundance and not of scarcity. Open our eyes to the possibility of full life when we give graciously and dream boldly. Amen. Let us take a moment of silence and reflect on our own lives, our own limitations, our own sins. And let us say together, Amen.
The mercy of the Lord is from everlasting to everlasting. And may the God of mercy, who forgives us all our sins, strengthen us in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep us in eternal life. I declare to you, in the name of Jesus Christ, we are forgiven.
Thanks be to God. As a given and reconciled people, let us give thanks and share a sign of Christ's peace with those around you. If you're joining online, we invite you to share the peace in the comments. And for those of us in the sanctuary, please share with a wave, a smile, a peace sign, a nod. The peace of Christ be with you.
And also with you. Good morning. Grace to you, and peace in the name of Jesus Christ, and welcome to worship here at Lafayette Avenue Presbyterian Church on this ninth day of Christmas. We are a diverse community where people of faith and no faith at all can come together, journey with one another, and experience the divine through openness and honesty, laughter and prayer, music and worship. Whether you're watching at home or here in person, it is our joy to worship with you this day. If you are a visitor, we're so glad that you're here. On your way out this morning, please say hello to somebody. Say hi to me in the narthex. Let us know that you're new here. We would love to get to know you. Friends, this morning, our order of worship might be a bit different than what you're used to. It might be a bit more meditative. It might even be participative. Can you handle it? In honor of Epiphany, the story of the Magi following the star, we're going to participate in the liturgical tradition of star words. Not Star Wars, star words. Later in the service, each of you will have a chance to receive your own star word, which, like the light that guided the wise men, might serve as a guiding principle, a challenge, a promise, a center for your meditation in 2022. To be honest with you, this is a tradition I have not yet participated in. And so this morning, thinking that maybe after 6 weeks of hearing from me, you might be ready for a new voice, I've asked my good friend and peer in ministry to share a meditation centered around this morning's practice. Virginia is a graduate of Princeton Theological Seminary, has served congregations from New Jersey to the Upper East Side, and brings considerable insight as a chaplain at a Trauma One Center, and most recently at New York Presbyterian Brooklyn Methodist Hospital. Will you join me in welcoming Virginia? Let's pray. God of endless light, you sent a star rising from the darkness to guide seekers and sages and to overwhelm us with your joy. Let the splendor of your dawning light grow in us and in all the world until the whole creation shines with your light. Loving God, Through Christ, you have called us all into your covenant with Abraham and with Sarah. May we be a faithful witness, denouncing injustice, declaring your wisdom, and working for the equity of all people. Particularly as we begin a new year, we pray for the leaders of government, that they would reject the way of Herod, that miraculously they would choose to exercise their authority not in selfishness, but in truth, in justice, and in mercy. For all the ways we have not been good stewards of this earth, your creation, we confess. And we humbly ask for the courage and the conviction to protect this world, our home. Merciful Creator, we remember and pray especially for all those who suffer from political oppression, from injustice, from war, and especially today for refugees. This morning, we lift up all within the Holy Family, every one of your children, every single person who draws breath, those within and outside our walls. We pray that they may live in peace. We pray for the goodwill of our neighbor, that they may be communities of flourishing this coming year. We pray all these things in the name of the light, the one who taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
Thank you.
Lord, open our hearts and minds by the power of your Holy Spirit, that as the scriptures are read and your word is proclaimed, we may hear with joy what you say to us today. Amen. Isaiah 60, chapters 1 through 9. Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord has risen upon you. For darkness shall cover the earth, and thick darkness the peoples. But the Lord will arise upon you, and his glory will appear over you. Nations shall come to your light, and kings to the brightness of your dawn. Lift up your eyes and look around. They all gather together, they come to you. Your sons shall come from far away, and your daughters shall be carried on their nurses' arms. Then you shall see and be radiant. Your heart shall thrill and rejoice, because the abundance of the sea shall be brought to you. The wealth of the nations shall come to you. A multitude of camels shall cover you, the young camels of Midian and Ephah, all those from Sheba, shall come. They shall bring gold and frankincense and shall proclaim the praise of the Lord. All the flocks of Kedar shall be gathered to you. The rams of Naboth shall minister to you. They shall be acceptable on my altar, and I will glorify my glorious house. Who are these that fly like a cloud and like doves to their windows? For the coastlands shall wait for me, the ships of Tarshish first, to bring your children from far away, their silver and gold with them. For the name of the Lord your God, and for the Holy One of Israel, because he has glorified you. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Listen now as we hear from the Lord, echoing from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 2, verses 1 through 12. In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem asking, "Where is the child who has been born King of the Jews? For we observed his star at the rising and have come to pay him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was frightened, and all Jerusalem with him. And calling together all the chief priests and scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. They told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for so it has been written by the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, and the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah. For from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people, Israel.' When Herod secretly called for the wise men and learned from them the exact time when the star had appeared, then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, 'Go and search diligently for the child. And when you have found him, bring me word so that I may go also and pay him homage.' When they had heard the king, they set out, and there ahead of them went the star that they had been seeing at its rising, until it stopped over the place where the child was. And then they saw that the star had stopped. They were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage. Then, opening their treasure chest, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they left for their own country by another road." The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. A couple of months ago, I was cleaning out my desk at work. Most likely, I was avoiding doing Medicare paperwork or charting, usually one of the both. As I was making a list of the other projects that I could do instead of the thing that I actually should be doing, I stumbled upon it. It was a neatly cut out paper star that I vaguely remember receiving last year after Christmas at Epiphany. Written across the star in neat handwriting was the word listening. I remember last year thinking to myself after being handed this word, I got this. I'm a good listener, I can do that. One of the characteristics that I'm actually proud of is my ability to shut up and listen to the stories and fears of other people. I mean, I literally made a career out of it. I'm one of those people that went to seminary, took preaching, and would throw up before each time I would preach. What I came to understand was that my extreme stage fright was most likely a fear of my own voice. So, I found a career in which some ways I get to focus on the voices of others. Or so I thought. So I'm pretty sure last year I was thinking to myself, praise the Lord, finally something I can do. I needed a win. I think we all probably needed a win last year. I think we still do. I needed something easy at that point. Even this activity at church that shouldn't have felt like a chore or another thing that I have to add to my list of to-dos at that point, I felt like I was at capacity. I felt and still feel like my capacity to hold on to life's difficulties has been stretched beyond what I deemed imaginable. I'm sure that most of us in here can relate to that feeling. This is to say, I needed a win. I needed God to do me a solid, throw me a bone, and let me do something that I would actually feel successful at doing. So when I heard and saw the word listening, I was relieved. I wouldn't have to do anything different. I wouldn't need a new activity to add to my plate, like if I got the word adventure, or the phrase like exercise every day or something. Listening felt familiar to me, and I needed something familiar. In Matthew, the Magi begin their journey, looking to the familiar to offer them answers. They hear of a newborn king, so they journey to the current ruler, Herod, hoping for comforting answers. And instead, they appoint themselves in a direction and start to follow the star through the desert in hopes that their way will become clear. Little do they know that they'll be a part of the welcoming party for a very long-awaited and surprising guest. I think it's always remarkable for me to think of such promise, love, an expectation to come from such a vulnerable thing, a baby. When finding my star word from last year, the surprising thing for me was the ways in which I was completely off the mark in my own assumptions of how listening would show up in my life this year. Rather than listening to the voices of my patients, or listening to the voice of God, I was ignoring the voice, mine. I focused so much on the lives of others that I allowed my own life to slip away to the fringes of my awareness. These past 2 years, I've been so caught up in the chaos of the world, of work, of relationships, that I ignored myself. I think I equated my own resilience with avoidance in hopes that ignoring my own issues, being able to carry on would mean that I was doing well. This past year, listening has turned my own pathological selflessness, or a focus on others, and complete focus on others, and show me what it really is. Fear. Fear of myself. Fear of confronting my own insecurities, my shortcomings, my strengths. I've been allowing my own fear to prevent me from living into the full life that God would have for me. So, when you pick your star word today, my advice is this. Take a word, and maybe it's something that's speaking to you now, who knows? Maybe it's a goal that you have for yourself. Maybe you don't like your word. It's fine. I want you to trust the process. I want you to trust yourself, to trust God, that the word that you pick may have one meaning today, but the meaning of the word can transform in new and liberating ways as you reflect on it throughout the year. Let these words be a physical reminder of the unexpected ways in which God can be at work in your life. We just need to be open to the possibility. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Please stand as you are able and join me as we affirm our faith together using the responsive reading in your bulletin. The grace of God has appeared, bringing salvation to all. Glory to God in the highest. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Glory to God in the highest. For a child has been born for us, a son who has been given to us. Glory to God in the highest. He is Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Glory to God in the highest. To us is born in the city of David, a Savior, the Messiah, the Lord. Glory to God in the highest. And the Word became flesh and lived among us. Glory to God in the highest.
Thank you.
I now invite us into a moment of giving. Giving at LAPC has never been easier. If you're joining us online, we encourage you to give at lapcbrooklyn.org/donate. If you're here in the sanctuary, there'll be a deacon after the service holding a plate where you may place your tithes and your offerings. This morning, we ask that you not only offer your financial gifts, but that just as the Magi did in following the star, you would bring your own gifts, be they frankincense, myrrh, or gold, or simply your presence, your willingness to show up, your openness to the work of God in your life and in that of others. So in that spirit, as a form of giving, during the offertory anthem, we invite you to this table to select a star. They are intentionally upside down, so there's no peeking, so that you might open yourself up to an unknown and new guiding principle for 2022. I invite you now to quiet your minds and open your hearts as we continue to listen for a word from God.
Oh. cielo che bagu alla terra le regalo nera quien spiera tristeza.
Friends, siblings, we are all invited to gather around this table. Regardless of how deserving we think we are, regardless of how tired we feel, regardless of how many degrees we have or how many convictions we have, this is God's table. We are all welcome here just as we are. Everything that we need is here. And so, in that spirit, if everything that we need is not here, if you did not grab the communion elements on your way in, please raise your hand so that an usher may serve you. Jesus, our sibling, born of Mary in a stable in Palestine, a vulnerable baby who would confront the powers and principalities of his time and ours, and who welcomed as friends the people whom society said were not good enough. He walked with them, he ate with them, and through shared meals he continues to teach us of abundance. And then Jesus, for the love and the liberation of his people, risked his life and was executed by the empire. Yet even death could not put an end to the love that he embodies. Out of death, he rose again to live among his people. We do not always understand the how, yet we celebrate the love that he shared with us, and with imperfect dedication, we follow him.
We ask of the Spirit that Jesus be present here as we share this bread and this cup. Through these ordinary things that sustain our bodies, may we be nourished and transformed, so that we remember that we belong to each other and to God. Through this remembering, may we also proclaim that there is enough for everyone. Through this remembering, may we remember that we are stronger together, that we are called to live together with justice, to support one another, to lovingly challenge one another, and to honor the spark of divine in one another. Amen.
We remember again the familiar story. On the night that Jesus was arrested by the authorities, he had gathered in an upper room with his closest friends to celebrate the Jewish story of Passover. And he took the bread, blessed it, broke it, and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, broken for you. Whenever you eat of it, remember me." And in the same way, after supper, he took the cup and said, "This is a new covenant poured out for you, sealed in my blood. And whenever you drink of this cup, remember me."
So now, following Jesus' example, we take these ordinary things and we remember the bodies that continue to be broken by the powers and principalities of our time. And we also remember the new relationship to which God continually calls us, relationship where peace comes through justice.
These are God's gift for us. Remember, taste, and be loved. Will you pray with me, using the words printed in your bulletin? O God, our mystery, you bring us to life, call us to freedom, and move between us with love. Now that we have been fed at your table, may we go into this wondrous and difficult world to build each other up, to confront powers and principalities, to live and love boldly into the promise that there is enough. Enough food, enough justice, enough love, enough peace, enough dignity for everyone. Amen.
Thank you.
repenting, Christ? See the signs of God's work in your life. Follow the star. As you lean upon the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit. Amen.